Hey guys, welcome to this special episode of Quarantine Social Distancing Prover Brothers. Now, today we're going to be teaching you how to make carrot cake using our own homegrown organic carrots right from our backyard. I'll have Josh tell you all about it.
Thanks, Justin. Yeah, so the reason that we are growing our own vegetables and food in our garden is simply this. COVID-19, as we know it, is the beginning of the apocalypse. Now, some of you know it as a virus. We know it as a beta test for AI software that is expanding its facial recognition portion of it from China. So, but you know, message us for more about that. The reason we are so keen to grow our own food is because we know that supermarkets are gonna be shut down. If you walk around now, you'll see Target, Walmart, Safeway, all these stores completely empty, completely shut down. So we need to make sure that we have all the food and ingredients that we need to survive. So that is why we started our own garden.
With that being said, carrot cake is just such a fun, easy way to incorporate homegrown food into a bake that can fill up our sweet tooth from bottom to top. We planted about 26, 25 or so carrots in the backyard about 4 months ago, and we're just about ready to reap our harvest. So let's get everything ready for the cake first, and then we'll go and dig up those carrots. So we're just gonna use basic cake ingredients, 1/2 cup flour. That was supposed to be the sugar and butter first. Just get that all back in there.
Oh gosh, come on.
Should have used a bigger bowl.
It's so necessary. Oh,
great. All right, 1 cup of sugar first. Add in that butter. Gonna cream Abdul-Jabbar those things together. That was not room temperature. Let's microwave these babies first. There we go. This is a lot easier. Eggies. 1, 2, 3. Ooh. Mixy, mixy. Just a hint of vanilla. Now let's do the dry boys. Just a little bit of baking powder. Ooh. This is real thick.
So thick.
I don't know.
Oh, milk.
Oh, we got the milk. Okay.
I'm gonna start the camera in 3, 2, 1. And cut.
Okay, so now we have our cake batter. Now this is perfect. What you should be looking for is a consistency similar to that of, well, all the ingredients before the cake is exposed to the flames. So somewhere between sort of like a liquid and a solid state. It's liquid, well, it's solid, depending on what you want to call it. So let's add our secret ingredient, which is the carrot. And we're gonna follow Justin back to the garden to see what we find in our harvest.
All right, so now at least we have everything else done. All we need is our last final ingredient, and that is our homegrown organic carrots. Let's look at our harvest, shall we? Huh. So I had planted about 24 over here and 2 over here, but it looks like we only have 1, but that's okay. All right, well, let's just pull this puppy out and see what kind of harvest we got, yeah? All right, ready? This might take a little bit. It's smaller than I expected, but maybe that's because it's organic, all the nutrients are packed into such a small package. We can work with this. So this is not enough for a cake. But what we're gonna do instead is make some cupcakes and have one of them be a carrot cupcake. That way, it'll be fun.
Okay, now for the super, super fun part. We've actually already poured our cupcake batter into these ruffled cupcake skins, or as I like to call them, ruffle pods. And we actually have a separate bowl. So this is gonna be our carrot cake mixture. So I'm gonna be grating our beautiful harvest into this batter, and then we're gonna then pour it into it, because we don't want them to be mixing, because if carrot gets into, well, actually doesn't make sense, does it? Because they're all separate. Anyway, make sure I just taste it to see. No. Is it still on?
Yeah.
We don't have time for this. Okay, so I'm gonna start grating. So hopefully you can start to see that beautiful orange, orange sprinkling. Okay, well, that was it. That was just, is this enough? Do you think it's enough?
We have to.
Okay, well, this is our carrot cake batter then. It doesn't even look like carrot cake at all.
All right, let's put this puppy in. 15 minutes or so, should be good.
Okay guys, while the cupcakes are in the oven, I'm gonna show you something that maybe most of you have no clue about. We have some leftover cake batter. Now, most of you are thinking, well, what am I gonna do with that? Bake another cake? Right? What you're gonna actually do with it is turn it into icing. It's very, very simple. So I'm gonna take the remaining cake batter and I'm gonna add some milk. So add about 1-2 milk. And then we're gonna add our sugar. Now cake batter isn't that sweet, so we're gonna add more sugar. And that's really it. Bring it down, and I'm gonna start mixing it. Now what's really cool about this is that it's a renewable way of cooking. We're gonna use every part of the animal, so to speak. So I'm gonna let this speed increase a little bit. Now what it's doing is it's folding air into the mixture. And we all know that air is the salt of cooking. So it's gonna be more flavorful. You hear that?
Pretty good. Now, we can't quite apply the frosting to the cake yet because it's the clues in the name. Frosting needs to be cold. So we need to make sure this is cooled down before we apply the cake batter frosting that we made. That way we ensure that it sticks very nicely.
Daddy likey. Now these look fantastic. If you touch them, they should be to the touch what most would consider like cake-like, spongy. So what I'm gonna do is take our cake batter icing and we're gonna start icing these little cakes. So the first tip really is to find a cake that you wanna make sure that it's a flat surface. Otherwise, everything's just gonna drip right off. So. Would you look at that? That's delightful, yeah? And many of you might have noticed this, but Justin and I, we don't really like color in food, food coloring, just general color. So we try to keep our cakes and our bakes very neutral. So that's why we have cakes that are white and then frosting that's also white. I think it's more pleasing to the eye. It's more exciting. It's more natural. And so this is just what we believe here at Prove It Brothers. But you are free to do whatever you want to do. But we just like this color scheme. I mean, just look at that, it's gorgeous. Now for the taste test. We're gonna have a fun little game where we're gonna bite into a cupcake and alternate, and whoever gets the carrot cake ultimately wins a grand prize of actually $10,000.
$10,000, that's right.
We've been sponsored by Hellmann's Mayonnaise. We never included that.
Did we not? Oh, they're gonna
be pissed. We'll do it in post.
Yeah, okay.
Hellmann's Mayonnaise. So thank you for the $10,000 cash prize. So whoever gets the carrot cake will become a millionaire.
The only prize I need is a tasty carrot cupcake. Mm. That $10,000 is nice too, though.
Yes, it's okay for some.
Let's dig in. Who wants to go first?
You go.
Rock.
You go first.
Let's do this. All right. I'm gonna pick one without frosting.
Okay. Well, and I'll do this.
Can you turn? All right. Yeah, I can.
So we shield ourselves still.
I mean, the cupcake is delicious, but unfortunately, I don't think I have the carrot one.
Okay, here is my choice. Mmm. Delicious cake. I don't see any carrot in it.
Here we go. That has a different texture. That shouldn't be the case, but it is, and I like it.
Okay. Mm. Here's my guess. Mmm. Huh. This has a caramel filling.
We didn't put it there.
We did not do that.
No. That's fun, though.
Do you know how that got there?
I mean, no, but that I think that's the joy of baking, is you really never know what you're going to end up with. Sometimes there's just no way to figure it out.
Hmm. Okay.
So, all right, let's go. But no carrot.
No carrot, right? Just caramel.
All right. So, I don't taste carrot.
Okay. All right. So that's not it.
Mm-mm.
I'm really wanting to avoid the ones with so much cake batter icing, but I think I need to
dripping.
Get it over and done with. Here we go. Hmm. That's burnt inside.
But not on the outside.
It's very soft. It's almost raw on the outside.
That's interesting.
Mmm. No carrot.
Hmm. That's... Oh. God, I can't see. Okay. Bone.
Why did you say bone?
I just forgot the second part.
Oh, the French word?
Yeah.
Appetite?
Yeah.
Any carrot?
Nope, that one's straight up raw.
Okay. So these were all baked in the same batch, correct?
Yes, in the same oven, same temperature, same...
Wait, so far we have one raw, one burnt on the inside, raw on the outside. We have a caramel one and one that is good.
Yes, that is correct.
Okay.
But no carrots so far.
No carrots.
Yeah.
Yeah, weird. Everything but the thing we really put into these things.
That's baking.
Here we go. Salty.
Ooh, okay, that wasn't an ingredient. All right. Do you see that?
Yeah.
It's like this black spot.
Yeah. Peppercorn? I did put a peppercorn in one of them.
Oh, so I got the peppercorn one.
Yeah.
Do I get any?
No, it has nothing to do with anything. It's just a joke.
You win some, you lose some.
Mm-hmm. We haven't won any yet, though.
No, that's true. That's
okay.
True.
Fingers crossed. I'm really hoping this is something.
And I hope it isn't.
Okay. Well, that's a scone.
It's a scone.
It's dry.
Let me... Yeah, there's no moisture at all in there. Huh.
Ooh, as dry as can be.
Huh. I don't know. Maybe the milk separated in the mixture,
Again,
so that some of them got some milk, some of them didn't, and lost that out on that hydration aspect of it.
Well, you know what they say, milk is like oil.
All right, well, it's 50-50 for me, so I'm gonna...
Why don't you ever try the icing?
I just don't want it.
I have all of them.
Yeah, but it's just
so sticky.
It's so runny.
Okay,
I don't like it at all.
Okay, fine.
All right, let's try this. Oh, geez, real crumbly. I don't taste anything.
Not even a cake?
No.
No. Oh.
It's like, I get the texture, the sponginess. We put vanilla in there. I don't taste that.
Wow.
Milk, sugar, flour, nothing.
Okay.
It's like a spongy water. Is what I'm eating.
Okay.
And I don't know why.
Oh, well.
That's weird.
So you know,
that's
you
weird.
You know what has happened though.
Okay, so, all right.
Someone's about to become very, very wealthy.
Yeah, I mean, that's how it is. You know, I was just unlucky this time, but that's the name of the game.
All right, well, we'll double check.
All right. You got the carrot in there?
And the icing is sticking to my teeth. Huh, I don't taste it.
Well, it'll probably be pretty subtle. The carrot we used was on the small end.
Yeah.
Is it orange?
No, it's neither orange, nor does it taste like anything. Well,
let's just dig through this, see if we can...
Maybe try and find...
Maybe we like, you know, some of the... Oh, because like some of these I only bit like the top end off, and the carrot is dense, so it might
have sunk.
Sink to the bottom.
Okay, it's not there.
Not that one.
Well, sorry, Hellman's.
This one has a hair in it.
Okay. I'm wearing a mask.
It's probably your head hair, not your beard hair, right?
Okay, well, sorry to disappoint, guys, but we set out to make a carrot cake, and instead we made 12 cupcakes that didn't contain any carrot.
Not at all.
Well, I hope you learned something.
Yeah.
We sure did.
Definitely. That was, is it safe to say that was unexpected?
Unexpected.
Usually there is a little bit of uncertainty with the end product when we bake. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the same with anyone's bake.
Yeah.
Sometimes you make a scone, sometimes you make a cupcake, sometimes it comes out as a croissant.
That makes sense.
Because they all use the same ingredients, so you don't really know.
Yeah, it's like tea. Made from tea leaves, but depending on the process, you make something else.
Like Earl Grey or coffee, you know?
They're
like
the two same things.
Same thing, different
outcomes.
Stuff.
But in this case, the main ingredient has gone missing.
Yeah, so I guess should we just split the prize money?
I don't think we'd get any money. Well, actually, because we didn't even put mayonnaise in this.
That's true.
Is there?
No, I forgot about that completely.
Okay. All right, well, thanks for joining us, guys.
Yeah.
We'll see you again next time.
Yeah, absolutely. Pib.